Let's start making kesar rasgullas by making fresh paneer or cheese. Heat milk in a vessel and bring it to boil. To ensure I don't burn milk, I have used a thick vessel. Once the milk starts to boil, add curd to curdle the milk. And stir continuously. Keep adding the curd until milk curdles completely, like this. I don't prefer lemon juice because it gives lemony flavor in rasgullas even after washing cheese thoroughly. Also, I think it makes rasgullas more chewier. Milk has been curdled completely and whey water is clear, as you can see. This yellowish water is called as whey. We have to curdle the milk till we reach this stage. Now go ahead and switch off the gas. Take a muslin cloth and strainer. Separate whey water from paneer like this, or you can directly pour in. Now add some cold water and rinse the cheese. This will make cheese to stop cooking further and also to get rid of the remaining whey. Squeeze the excess water and leave it in a strainer for 30 minutes to 1 hour, or you can hang it. Meanwhile, chop the nuts to stuff them into rasgullas. This is optional. I am chopping pista and almonds. You could use any nuts of your choice. Let's start the process of kneading the cheese. I have left paneer for about 1 hour. Paneer would be crumbly in texture like this. If you hung cheese for more time, the cheese will go dry and you might have challenges in kneading the cheese to get the smooth dough. Now knead it well using your heel of the palm for 2 to 3 minutes. Add 1 teaspoon of semolina. This will help to hold the shape, however it's optional. If you don't have semolina, you can skip this step. Now add few drops of food color, yellow food color. Knead the dough again for 8 to 10 minutes. Stop kneading the dough once the cheese starts to ooze out oil. Look at my hand. Paneer is oozing out the oil. I'll stop kneading the dough. Pinch a portion of dough, press it little bit at center to stuff the dry fruit mixture. Cover it and make smooth balls. I made around 18 balls. Let's start making sugar syrup. Till then, cover the cheese balls with a muslin cloth. We are going to make rasgullas in batches as we don't want to overcrowd the pan. So accordingly, let's make the sugar syrup. Add 1.5 cup of sugar and 3 cups of water, few strands of saffron and 2 cardamom. Dissolve the sugar in medium flame. Once the sugar is dissolved, increase the flame to high. As syrup starts to boil, add cheese balls slowly into the pot. Remember, we are making them in batches. Close the lid as soon as cheese balls are dropped inside the syrup and do not open the lid. Cook them in high flame for 5 minutes and reduce the flame to medium to low for 8 to 10 minutes. Open the lid after 8 to 10 minutes. To check if rasgullas are cooked properly, take one rasgulla and drop them in a cup of water. If it sinks in water, that means rasgullas are cooked. Switch off the flame immediately. Transfer the cooked rasgullas in a bowl along with the half of sugar syrup. To cook the next batch, add half a cup of sugar and 1 cup of water to the same pan. And follow the same process to cook rasgullas what we have followed for the first batch. So there was already some sugar syrup was left over from the first batch of cooking. So I have added extra sugar and the water to the same pan. So you could use the same method if you're cooking it in batches. We have finished cooking the rasgullas. Cool it down and chill it until serving time. They are soft, spongy and perfect. All the ingredients and the measurements are available in description box below. Or you can get them at www.cookerystudio.com. Thanks for watching the video. If you like my recipes, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and give a thumbs up to the video. See you next time with another delicious recipe.